Good morning, everybody. Dr. Evan here with Dr. Evan's Almost Daily Dose. I hope everyone's having a wonderful day. So today, I want to talk about how to fix your constipation. But first, if you haven't met me before, my name is Dr. Evan Hirsch. I'm a functional medicine MD, and I specialize in helping people resolve their chronic fatigue. I'm on a mission to help 100,000 people, and I'm going to do this by blog posts, the book I wrote, classes, and then of course seeing patients in my clinic here at the Hirsch Center for Integrative Medicine in Olympia, Washington. So let's dive in. So how to fix your constipation? Well, first of all, are you constipated? So a lot of times when I ask people, you know, are you regular? They'll say, yes, I'm regular. I go regularly every 3 days. Well, that's not regular. You want to go to the bathroom. You want to stool twice a day, ideally. Once a day may be okay, but you want to make sure that you have a really good evacuation. The stool should look like a banana, and it should be brown, and it should be soft. It should be easy to get out, and you shouldn't have any residual where you feel like you're not emptying completely, where you have a lot on the toilet paper, a lot of stool on the toilet paper. Now, I'm a doctor. I talk about this all day long. This may make you feel upset. My mother-in-law, when she first came to work with us, did not want to hang out with us in the lunchroom because, yes, we talked about poop, but poop is so incredibly important. You know, it's phase three detoxification of the body, where you're dumping toxins out of your liver into your stool, and then if you don't get them out, guess what happens? They get reabsorbed. So if you're not pooping twice a day, you are reabsorbing your toxins back into the body. So you're just re-exposing yourself to any plastics and heavy metals, chemicals, molds, infections, all of these things that you're trying to get out of your body. So it's so incredibly important. So that's the first thing. So are you constipated? The next thing is, what symptoms might you have if you are constipated? Well, you're going to have bloating. You're not going to be stooling regularly. You may have early satiety or feel like you are full very early in the meal where you don't need to eat anymore. And then, you know, in terms of the causes of constipation, so one of the sinister ones that people don't really think about is thyroid. So if you have a low thyroid, your metabolism is slowed down, but so is your gut motility. So you're not moving things through your gut as fast as possible, and consequently, you are going to be constipated. The next one is probiotics. So depending on if you have an infection in the gut, if you've got good bugs, bad bugs, whatever, that can definitely disrupt your gut flora and how you process your stool. If you've had chronic antibiotics, that is also going to disrupt how your gut is populated with all of the good bugs. Another cause is not enough water. So if you're not drinking about 70 to 90, almost 100 ounces of water a day, 6 to 8 glasses of water a day, you are probably dehydrated, and that may be a big cause of your constipation. Next is movement. So if you're not moving every day, and this is a big problem for a lot of my fatigue patients, is that they're not moving. And so you have to get your lymph moving, you have to get your gut moving. And even if it's just jumping jacks every day, 5 jumping jacks a day, or as many as you can do without wasting your energy, super duper important for getting your bowels moving. So we talked about thyroid and probiotic and hydration and movement. Food is such a huge component of this. So there's food toxins or food allergies like dairy and gluten that play a huge role in constipation. I was actually constipated for most of my life until I got rid of dairy. Plays a huge role. And then making sure that you're increasing your fiber, making sure that you're getting your nuts and seeds and green leafy vegetables and all of these things. The next thing is magnesium. So magnesium deficiency can play a huge role in constipation. In fact, this is one of the main treatments that I use for getting rid of constipation, is that I recommend that people take a little bit of magnesium and increase every 3 nights, because magnesium is great for sleep as well. And eventually you get to what's called bowel tolerance, where you will hit a point where you are going to the bathroom. And if you overshoot it, you'll have some diarrhea and you have to come back a little bit. And I call that the magnesium ramp up, and I talk about it all in my book. So check it out, it's on Amazon. The next thing in terms of causes of constipation, so we talked about thyroid and hydration and movement and probiotics and foods and magnesium. And those are, oh, and then another one is autoimmunity. So if someone has a lot of inflammation in the gut from autoimmunity, like Crohn's, irritable bowel syndrome, inflammatory bowel disease, all of those are kind of the main causes that I have found with constipation. And so in terms of treatment, I talked about magnesium, but you want to make sure you're taking a good probiotic. You want to make sure that you're off gluten and dairy. You want to make sure that you are consuming all the foods that you're supposed to and not the ones that you're not, like I talked about with gluten and dairy. But green leafies, another one that's really important also is fats, making sure that you're getting good fats. So coconut oil, which has medium chain triglycerides, which has a little bit of a laxative effect. Extra virgin olive oil, making sure that it's organic and really pure because it can go rancid really quickly. So those can also really help. Making sure that your thyroid is treated, making sure that you're consuming enough water, like I spoke about, and making sure that you're moving. So I hope that this was helpful for you. If you learned something, give it a thumbs up. If you know someone who's suffering with fatigue and or constipation, please tag them in the comments below. Just put their name in and they'll be notified to check out this video. If you haven't already, check out my book on Amazon. Oh, I gotta show you something exciting. Here's the paperback with a whole bunch of edits. So I'm going through proofing this right now so that I can get that out to those of you who don't have access to Kindle. I'm very excited about that, and I'm gonna have a book launch at some point. And if you're interested in coming to see us at the Hirsch Center, go to thehirschcenter.com and fill out the new patient paperwork so you can be accepted as a patient. So I hope this was helpful. Have a wonderful day.